My name is Wenjing Guan. I'm the horticulture specialist at the Southwest Purdue Agriculture Center. This video, we are talking about growing strawberries in soil in your high tunnels. The strawberries around me are planted in September last year, and we are harvesting them now in April. A few things make us thinking this production have a high potential. First, these plants have a great potential to achieve a high yield. This is because after the plug plants are planted in fall last year, they are continuing growing in fall and into the winter. The protection provided by the high tunnels in the winter, especially during sunny days, could allow the temperatures to stay pretty high. That allows the plants to continue growing into the winter, initiate flowers, developing root. All this is support a good harvest in the spring. A second advantage of growing strawberry in the tunnel system is the advanced harvest. We noticed that in southern Indiana, we typically enter the peak harvest around the middle April, especially on early cultivars. And if growing a combination of early, middle, late cultivars, harvest could last from entire April and May. Typically, we end the harvest in May. This is because entering to the June, the temperature inside of the tunnels can be pretty high to the level to damage the fruit. And another reason is typically at the end of May and early June, the field strawberries are ripe, so the value of growing strawberry in the tunnels is reduced. The third advantage we observed for this system is because there's no free water. There's no rain inside of the tunnel, so no free water in the foliage. So the foliar disease pressure was significantly reduced. Another big advantage we saw for this system is to reduce the production risk, especially for the spring frost damage. With the protection of the structure, in addition to using floating row covers, typically, we won't have problem for the late spring frost. As I said, we start harvesting April, so the full bloom happens in March. We have been went through a few pretty heavy frost in March, but with in addition to the floating row covers, we didn't lost any single flower. And last but not least, the strawberry growing in the tunnels have a high quality, and the fruit is much clearer than the berries from the growing outside in the open field. Another thing make us feel growing strawberry in the tunnel have a great potential, that is from a high tunnel management aspect. We see more and more high tunnels are building in our areas. The crops most commonly grown in tunnels are tomatoes, cucumbers, peppers. They are great crops growing in the tunnels, high yield, high market value. But those crops are warm season crops. They like the heat. So they are planted in spring and the production season lasts from summer to fall. They like the heat in the summer and that's the best time to grow these crops. But strawberry is different. The production season for the strawberry is from fall, winter to spring. And what this means is growing strawberry in the tunnels fruit the summer months. And really, in the summer, we could do a lot of great things to help manage the tunnel. For example, growing cover crops to improve soil fertility or applying the soil disinfection techniques. Those are environmental friendly ways to control pests. So with that consideration, strawberries have a great potential as a rotational crop in your high tunnel systems. We have been exploring this system for a few years and we definitely learned a lot. We kind of figured out the varieties have the great highest yield potential of growing in these systems. We learned a lot over the years. There are definitely more questions also arise and we need additional research to figure out. Pest management is a big thing. I mentioned earlier this production system helped with foliar disease, but not really for the insect pest. And some of the major insect pests that we noticed that, including two-spotted spider mites, like aphids, also in the fall, we see the armyworms can be limitations for the system. We have built a strong team to work on the pest management. Dr. Laura Ingwell is doing research to develop a pest management program for this strawberry production system. We also noticed that after we continue on growing strawberry in the soil, we are building soluble disease. So Dr. Dan Eagle is keeping a close eye on what we might see in this system. On the culture aspect also, there's a lot of things we still need to learn. One of the things is that we noticed the early cultivars might flower in the winter. This is not a good thing because those flowers can be easily killed in the winter by the low temperatures. We are thinking to manipulate the planting date, trying to avoid those cultivars flower in the winter, but maximize the yield in the spring. Another aspect is the taste. It's very important to achieve a balance between high yield and good taste. We find the variety selection and the fertility management is the key to achieve this balance. Our team is very excited about this project, and we are continuing our research to figure out a lot of these things. Hopefully in the next few years, we will develop a comprehensive production guide for you for growing strawberry in the tunnels.